putting the pig mask out.
Oh, it stinks.
But you left it?
He told me to leave it here. It's been sticking up the house for days.
Hey, everybody. I'm Sam.
I'm Caleb.
And I'm Will.
And we are Working
Settle.
Sleep. Sleep. It's just me now.
Y'all.
You're up.
Y'all, we are back. It is Demon Slayer, Mugen Train Arc, Episode 6, Akaza.
Akaza.
Akira.
That's not it.
Akaza.
Akaza. Go ahead.
Akaza.
Last on, Inosuke actually became the main character of the show. He gave orders to Tanjiro and Rengoku, Nezuko and Zenitsu on how to best take care of the train. In reality, Rengoku came up with this plan. He gave full credibility to our gang, which was really impressive and awesome on his behalf. Our team stepped up. We figured out how to take down Enmu.
Enmu.
Lower one.
Enmu one.
Sliced the nape and might be dead. The train was collapsing.
That's how you kill a Titan. Did you guys know that? From the hit show, Attack on Titan.
So guys,
okay.
So guys, if y'all enjoy our reaction, leave a like, hit the subscribe button and notification bell so you know when more Demon Slayer comes out. Comment down below what you think about this episode. And we got a Patreon if y'all want to see the show 1 week, 2 weeks in advance, or to support the channel, hit the link in the description or on the screen. We appreciate it.
And make sure you go check out Demon Slayer, especially the Mugen Train arc or movie, whatever preference you prefer. And then come back and watch your boys. We're gonna punch it.
Bah! Bangarang. Bangarang? Bangarang.
Boss fight!
Bro, he saved you, rat.
He wanted that sweet dream.
Wonder what his sweet dream would have been.
I think his family.
Driving a train.
I think he said he wanted to be with his family.
Oh. No, that was the...
Oh, the ticket guy.
This is the conductor, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes, let's watch it again.
Let's see the flesh bulbs.
Yeah, because the final part of this episode was so intense that they have to build us back up to that for whatever the hell is going to happen next.
This is how I feel playing Monster Hunter.
Slice and die!
Big sword attack.
This was great.
Inokami.
Father, please protect me is so hyped to say before you cut something, dude.
And then again. Wow!
That thing smells like a wet dog, dude.
Can you smell it?
I can smell it from here.
Maybe it's just me.
Yeah.
Three times over.
Hey, bro, they play. It's cool.
It's a good scene.
It's so cool.
Of all scenes, it's a good scene to replay.
Yeah,
he's dead. That's how I want to go off.
How I'd be whispering in the girl's ear.
Whoa, shit, grab him.
I can't die. Okay.
Damn.
Oh my gosh.
Bro, what the fuck?
Oh, it's like Transformers, bro.
That's a little more noble than I would be.
Oh.
Wow.
Y'all lucky. Bro, all
this. It's like giant inflatable. It saves the impact.
Santaro.
It's kind of creepy that there's no lights on the train now.
Yeah, it's very cool.
Is your belly okay?
It's all up to you, dude.
We don't know.
That dude's gotta be dead. Or no skin like who?
It's okay if he dies.
Oh,
動けなくなってるぜ。足が潰れても歩け。ほっときゃ。
だったらもう十分罰は受けてる。助けてやってくれ。頼む。
When did he atone for his sin?
Like I was taking back an injury, I guess.
Tanjiro gets stabbed in the gut and he gets broken leg.
言ってやる。親分だからな。
Because I'm the
worst.
Minions.
Ah, but they be that.
Banana.
So they, did he really win right there? Or they really win?
This sucks if this is what winning looks like.
Yeah.
All things considered, it's not the worst.
It's better than the last lower demon that he faced.
True.
They're fine, but
that was like multi-injury. That was when Nosuke's head's crushed. The other one, oh, shit.
Oh, no.
It's so gross.
Of course it's still alive. Ew. Oh, no, it's not.
Ugh. I think you are. Oh, Muzan might kill you, bro. Muzan won't kill because he's unsatisfied with what Enmu did.
So he's literally saying this wasn't even my final form.
Yeah.
I didn't get to try.
You're not even gonna get the pleasure of Muzan killing you.
Yeah, he's too good, man.
He didn't carry.
Maybe this is how we get that other demon in the story, a vendetta against Rengoku.
He was very quick.
Yeah, he was still asleep. What's that about?
It's like, bro, what the fuck? Traitor!
That's a good point.
Dude, why has Muzan killed any of these people? That's what we've been saying.
See? He's really smart.
Oh, there you go. Yes, you are going to lose. Good riddance.
Hold this L, loser.
Whoa.
That's a swordsman. That one's a swordsman.
Whoa!
Why did they have a samurai?
Oh, there's a guy. Look at all these other ones. Holy moly.
One of them is a samurai.
Yeah, good enough.
Sorry, pal. You fucked up.
Bro, we keep missing the opportunity to get this blood from these people. From these, you know, ranked demons.
It's
just one of them. Yes, you will.
He asked him to train under him, right?
Yeah.
He's probably smarter.
Do it better.
Two flames.
Come on.
Gotcha, what?
From his breathing, he can like focus it there?
Breathe so hard you
what?
Fit your slice wound.
Well, he needs a reason to go visit Kaneo. All the healers.
This is not gonna be good. Sam's right. One of those upper are gonna have a vendetta. Yep. Whoa.
Yo, I thought that was a train or car like.
And he gets a heavy metal intro.
Oh, is he Akaza? Akaza? The name of the title?
Oh, why does he look like that?
Akaza. We get to learn his name before freaking Enmu.
Yeah.
Lord.
He looks sick.
Oh,
whoa,
my God.
Hopper 3!
We upgraded a little bit, boys.
Yeah.
Top three.
So somebody's dying.
Yeah, there's no fucking way.
And I think he has a voice you'll recognize.
Oh shit!
Silent as can be.
Whoa, okay, good. Rising scorching sun.
His arm, you see that?
He's quiet.
いい方だ。再生が早い。この圧迫感と凄まじい危機。これが上限。俺と君が何の話をする。初対面だが、俺はすでに君のことが嫌いだ。そうか。俺も弱い人間が大嫌い。弱者を見ると虫唾が走る。What?物事の価値基準が違うようだ。Yep.
では素晴らしい提案をしよう。Die? お前も鬼にならないか。ならない。お前の。I
think I'd be sadder than I go be dying.
Yeah.
That'd be like the ultimate betrayal of who he is. Against immortality. Your powers can live forever. I wonder if it's at least tempting because he's seen at least how Nezuko is.
Yeah.
She seems to be fine. Good job, Nezuko. Don't make him your subjects, though.
Why not? It'd be safer that way. Look at him. He's a hero. This boy isn't a weak.
Shit. I'm happy for you, but I'm not. Not hopeful. Oh, God.
Oh, snow!
Shit!
I love this theme so much.
That's pretty cool. Yeah, I like it
so good.
Are you gonna do that anyway?
Damn!
He just throws hands.
Oh!
He just throws hands.
Oh
my god, wow. That's so cool.
Damn. So he's killed other Hashira.
Damn.
Oh,
I hate that.
He's punching the sharp part of the sword.
Whoa.
Air type. Okay, so air demon? Or like, see, like, you know what I mean? Like, it comes off almost like Demon Slayer stuff.
Don't break your sword.
Air. Wow.
You both are fast as hell. I mean, like, what are we talking about?
That visual of him colliding with the fist is crazy.
Get close.
What's up?
Oh, he's shook.
There you go.
Oh. He's just punching the sword.
Oh, gosh. Yeah. Stand back.
Guys, just gotta watch.
What are they gonna do against an upper rank?
I don't know.
Can Zen join? He's fast.
Shit. Holy shit. Oh,
Goblin. Join the dark side, man.
No.
He just wants a sparring partner forever. I don't like you.
Me neither, man.
We
I'm
don't
Goku.
Have the same ideology, sir. Please stop asking. Blazing Universe. See, that's a good name.
Still cut him with an edit.
Oh, shit.
He's like, bro, what?
Yeah. But Zen could! Maybe! Wake up!
You don't know how fast his fast is.
I have no idea.
He's fast, but is he even Goku and this guy fast?
Probably not.
Sheesh.
Even Inosuke knows he'd be a detriment in this fight.
Yeah. Oh!
It's so annoying, this guy's like tempting him over and over again.
Oh my, oh, it split his head
with the threat of his death.
Oh,
Shinonui.
Why?
Oh. Damn.
Oh.
Oh. I feel like Rengoku's not landing anything on this guy. Like, he's struggling and the other guy's, like, smiling through all of it. Look at that.
Oh, dude, his eye. Fucked up.
Frank did it.
He fainted. Flame Tiger! Yes!
Yes!
Let's go!
Come on.
No way. That's a complete bull.
There's no way. No way.
Nah. I don't think he did.
Oh no. Oh fuck.
Did he got him?
Shit. What happened? What happened? Is he dead from the punch? I'm so confused what's going on. Oh my god.
You don't get to know yet.
Should've just watched the movie. Maybe we wouldn't have to wait for this.
Maybe you would've known what happened if you just watched the movie.
I'm not gonna lie, I've never paid attention to this.
No, neither. Same.
I really like the visuals of this. Almost more than the intro.
Him standing still is a little frightening.
Terrifying. I mean, he's still breathing, right? We saw him breathe.
I don't know, set your heart ablaze. Might be out. One final Fight? Plus Ultra?
Final episode.
Set your heart ablaze.
We'll fulfill my duty.
Don't start the next episode. Oh no, we accidentally watched the finale.
Oh no, we did record
Bro,
it.
Bro, I saw the funniest tweet. This YouTuber I follow on Twitter was like...
Who is it?
Not shouting him out. Sean C, he's funny. He does like music reviews and he did...
Sean C is cool, yeah.
Yeah, and he's doing
he's watching
reactions, and I think he was like... Oh, I accidentally tripped and fell and watched all of Stranger Things season 4, so no videos. I was like, you fucker.
Yeah, I think he recently just did Demon Slayer.
He did all of Entertainment Arc, and during that video, he was like, am I going to watch all of these right now? I was going to break these up into multiple videos, and he just watched like all of them in one video. He's like, dude, it's like 2 in the morning. I stayed up all day watching this.
Dude, I love Sean C. Sean C's awesome.
His Twitter's so cursed.
It is.
It's a cursed place.
It is a cursed place.
It's cursed.
That was episode 6, Akaza.
Akaza.
The Akaza.
The Yakuza. You boys nervous?
Yeah.
A little bit frightened?
I don't know what I think will happen with Goku.
Me neither.
It is, I'm trying to, like, cheat in my mind and think of how much people like him and, like, cosplay as him. I'm like, would they cosplay somebody that's only in one season? Possible.
Yeah.
Possible.
I think he has a pretty solid impact overall. Like, if he was to be done after this, like, I could see people, like, still really... It's not like they killed a red shirt, you know what I mean? Like...
Maybe,
I can't imagine he's dying, though.
Yeah, see, all my theories when it came to Rengoku and whether he would live or die when Adam was asking us, a week ago, whenever it was, 2 weeks ago, was all having to do with Enmu. Like, I thought the sleep demon might get him, because...
OP.
Well, because how Adam was explaining it was seeming like if somebody falls into the dreams, they won't necessarily die, but like their soul would be crushed, like the soul, their spirit and who they are would, and maybe that physically takes a toll on you, maybe not kill you, but like you might be like these people on the train. So little spoiler, go like 20 seconds ahead real quick for My Hero season 4. Okay, good. Kind of like Mirio, like maybe not die and be off the show, but kind of like rendered useless for the preceding stories. That's kind of what I felt like, but now with this story, how I come back, now with this portion of the story, he could die.
Yeah.
I don't know. I really don't know. Especially with an episode called Set Your Heart Ablaze.
Yeah. I feel like that means, like, he is going to put it all on the line, and he might come out on top, but he might also die in the process.
Yeah.
So...
Okay, if you had to take bets right now, he can't because he's already seen it. If you had to guess, crippled and utterly or physically useless for helping the cause, or dead, which one would you go with? Or, I guess third option we should throw in, he's fine. He comes out victorious, All Might style.
I'm going to err on the positive side because I was negative and thinking someone was going to die. I'm hoping that they'll pull, he's victorious, he pulls through at the end. All Might style.
All Might style.
I don't know.
All Might... He could be rendered useless after this. I'll say victory rendered useless.
So no longer Hashira useless?
Okay. If you're going to go... You're going to go more pessimistic. I was going to go dead, so I'm going to go against that just to make the odds interesting. I'm going to say he lives.
That's not pessimistic. Pessimistic would
he's
be
crippled.
Yours. No, you're... You said he dies?
I was saying, survives full victory, crippled, useless, but still gets the win, but his win is not really there, because he's now gone and then dead. So, since you're middle ground, I'm going to go positive, because I want a good outcome.
Okay. Yeah.
Caleb, your thoughts on...
You're
thinking? What
you thinking?
Would you choose?
What would you choose?
Man? I would choose.
Don't do it.
I like the one where he's orange and he's fighting the blue man.
Nice.
Yeah.
Good job.
It's a good episode, though.
Yeah.
That's really good.
Really fun episode.
We started with the lower one. Oh, yeah. We relived the moment for the third time.
We watched so many Hinokami Kaguras for one intro.
Yeah.
Just say, like, what was it called?
Clear Blue Sky.
After 3S, the
clear
whole
blue, clear Blue Sky. It's such a cool attack name.
It's really hard when the show is really beautiful that I'm expected to have to read when there's really cool fights going on.
Yeah.
I will say, during most of the Akaza and...
You weren't reading
Kyojuro fight,
Kyojuro,
I was just obsessed and possessed with looking up top and not really reading a whole lot of the bottom.
I felt like I was like, oh.
Yeah, there's I was trying to, and then I
a lot of fight up. Banter, you're fine.
Yeah.
Become demon, no, okay.
Yeah. We caught up with the train falling over. You know, Tanjiro really wanting to save the conductor. Because he doesn't want to, and he doesn't want to die himself because he doesn't want to make that guy a murderer.
Yeah.
Even though that's not, it's not.
It's a weird way to look at it, but yeah.
Yeah, it's such a odd. I like that he tries to be like really positive and care for other people, but it's like if you died, that's his fault. That's not your fault that you died to cause someone to be a murderer. Like, he did the attacking. So.
Yeah, maybe, I don't know how the legal system works in Japan at this era, but maybe it's like a,
it was probably really strict, so don't worry about
so
that.
So maybe it's like this guy after this, if he lives on, might get accused of being a murderer. I'm saving him from getting that level of punishment by not dying.
I don't think it's coming down from like a not political, but like a like real outcome. I think it's more so that he doesn't want the guy to have like the conscience on his mind that he murdered somebody.
Like,
I feel like that's
double
more.
Double. I feel like all around, because Tanjiro's super sweet. Maybe he's thinking long term. But
I mean, there was a train crash. Oh, he died in the crash. You know what I mean? Like, that's it's all it is for them. But
yeah, it's true.
Tanjiro rolled off. Inosuke made sure that he was alive, and Tanjiro asked him to go save the guy. Inosuke was like, he doesn't matter, he tried to kill you. And he's like, no, he broke his leg, he atoned for his sins. Then we got the blob of Lower One rolling out, basically pissed at himself for A, not reaching his full potential, and B, that he lost to all of these people that thwarted him. Not just like one specific person, but each of them.
Literally, he was so mad at all of them.
Yeah.
He had examples for each one. He's like, you did this, I hate you.
I will say, in my mind, almost a missed opportunity, I feel like, story-wise with that death. I thought it could have been cool if, like, I don't know how powerful Muzan is, if he's able to see through the eyes of the uppers and what they do on their daily tasks. I would assume maybe, because he noticed that the lowers weren't doing anything grand. I don't know how he knows, but maybe... I don't know, I kind of wanted a moment where, like, Muzan was, like, watching and, like, discredited the demon for not accomplishing and then not... I mean, he didn't die by Muzan's hand in the end, but I thought it would have been better if he was like, I could off you right now.
But
well, you didn't do good enough. Just to, like, be more petty.
Yeah. Okay. And Enmu brought up a really good point. So, why... And I know I said it. Why does Muzan let Nezuko live? And you go, well, why does he let anyone live? That's not the point, though. He has control over every demon.
Mm-hmm.
To, like, mm-hmm. a scary degree. Like,
he
was the one who...
If Muzan wanted to say, Sam, die right now, you would die. There is no debate about that. Or he would just show up and just do it himself. Like, why is he letting Nezuko live?
Well, he was the one to make her, too. That's the thing. Supposedly, the scent came from him.
Yeah. But that's my thing. It's just like, so why... Like, what's the purpose? Like, why is he still...
Oh, man. What if it's like,
Like, is this a long game to get, like a sleeper agent demon that eventually, when it gets close enough to, you know, whatever his ultimate goal... Maybe when Nezuko gets strong enough on her own, like, without eating humans, that when she's... I mean, I don't know. It doesn't really make sense because all the people that I feel like she would have killed would have been the Hashira slash the master, and she was in their presence, and he didn't do anything. But that's, unless it's like the time's not right, she's not strong enough.
That's
yet.
So Palpatine.
Yeah, it's, I mean, that feels cool. Very
like it's like grooming Anakin to be the sleeper agent of the Jedi. That's like the best analogy I can think of, because I mean that makes sense. Because Nezuko, if Muzan's as grand as he is, which I would proclaim he is, because he seems like he's very
seems
intelligent,
like almost omnipotent. Like
maybe
yeah.
maybe his goal is okay. My Hashira, as grand as they are, have not been the best. Maybe
12.
Yeah, maybe let the Hashira train this girl. Let this kid. Okay, maybe I'm giving a lot of credit to the father. Maybe he knows the father and knows that Tanjiro will be like his father. Maybe do exactly as we saw all season one. Tanjiro, being the kind person he is, maybe like his father, takes the sister, supposed to be trained by the Hashira, to become this grand soldier to eventually be turned. I don't know. But the reason that my epiphany when you were saying that, as with your epiphany, was like, doesn't Muzan have to like... I guess he doesn't have to, but normally every time we see him give power, it's like a decision. Like, we never saw the moment with Nezuko. We don't really know much about Nezuko prior
yeah.
to this.
Yeah.
Would she be the type of person that maybe something in her life made her feel the need to do some blood pact? Was it completely accidental? Was there a mix of both? She maybe submitted to him and then didn't know it cost her the family? Like,
yeah.
is there
I mean,
more
it
to
could
it?
Have, it could have been, like, I don't know how old she's supposed to be. I mean, I feel like she's, like, 12 in this. But I also feel like when we first met her, like, when she was in the white robe, when Tanjiro went away, I thought that she was, like, mom's age.
I thought.
You know
still,
what
I
mean? I
still get confused.
So, I don't know. And she also changes sizes. Like, one episode she looks like a baby. The next she looks like she's the same age as Tanjiro. So, I don't know how old she is. But, like, what if, at the time... Like, even, like, if Muzan, like, seduced her. Not, like, I'm not trying to say, like, sexually. But, like, you know, it could be. But I'm saying, like, if he seduced her to be a friend or, like, he was going to bring her hand in marriage. And that's when, like, if you join me and I give you this, like, ability that I have, like, he could have swooned her in some way. Then, like, you know, whatever.
Yeah.
Or he killed the whole family and was like, I'll bring them back if you become a demon. But you can't speak, ever.
I mean, that goes hand-in-hand.
No speaky.
That goes hand-in-hand with, like, the grooming for command, too. Grooming,
yeah.
Grooming a child and grooming for more stuff in the future, so...
Yeah.
Could be Muzan's move. I don't know. Maybe we're just shooting a shot in the dark.
Yeah,
there's definitely stuff to be read from that, because it's, like, the main plot point of the whole show.
Yeah.
Like, this is why we're here.
Yeah, that's just, like, why I would be like, what, can we get a little more of that?
Yeah.
Please.
Yeah.
For me.
For me, please.
Also, just before the scene's over, I also, I'm always critical towards the repetition of Tanjiro's...
Sweethearted Will.
But I liked that today we got some advancement with that, where it's not just him doing it himself, he's encouraging his friends to do it.
That's true.
Yeah.
He made it a point for Inosuke to follow suit.
Go help these people, please. I can't do it.
Yeah.
And that's where his character can shine a bit more with his friends. And maybe his friends... I don't think his friends are some like sadistic assholes that wouldn't really...
But they're just not as
that.
Like kind-hearted as he is.
Yeah. Well, it's also more seeds for maybe the Hashira that need that kind of lifestyle. Like we saw briefly with
yeah.
Shinobu, who's having a hard time accepting that form of life with the demons, but...
Yeah. Also, I just gotta bring it up. I gotta bring it up because people, the comment section is absurd. So you mean to tell me that Tanjiro was too weak to beat number 5 or 6? Which one was Rui? Was he 5 or 6?
Rui was he was 11. He's lower 5.
So he's lower 5. He was too weak to learn lower 5, and then he healed himself. Not himself, but he got healed. And then learned to breathe better, and then was able to kill one.
Going crazy.
That, like, that, to me, that's just dumb.
Like, they have to come at you for that.
Wait. One wasn't just one at that point, too. Didn't Muzan give more blood?
No, he was buffed, for sure.
Honestly,
he was.
It's anime.
No, I'm fine. That's fine if it's anime. But if these... commenters are going to rage that, like, oh, you guys can't understand nuance. You can't understand storytelling. You can't understand this bullshit.
Literally.
Like,
nuance?
I mean, like,
it's an anime. It's a kid's cartoon from Japan.
This ain't even Attack on Titan. Like,
there's no higher learning unless he fights with a sword.
I don't care. It's fine. I won't throw my gripes out about it that much.
This is all fun. I like all this.
I love this. This is a great.
He breathed into board and now he can flip up a demon.
I agree. But I said that I was going to call out the comments if this happened, which
you
did. Great.
And you know what? I already know what they're going to say. Well, he didn't do it alone. He did it with Inosuke. That's fine.
Well, technically, he did it with everyone, but they were fighting
against. But Inosuke got capped by a non-lower. He got capped by the dad.
But he lifted rocks for months. He lifted three boulders for so many months.
So, like,
I'm sure he lifted rocks before that.
But he didn't lift three.
He probably lifted boards.
He didn't lift three.
But Inosuke, they all learned.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah,
they all learned
total
to do the breathing.
My bad.
Jesus Christ.
Sorry.
They all learned to do the breathing better. Tundra clearly did it the best.
So he just ran faster.
I'm just saying.
Maybe that's prime importance because today he learned how to heal his body from breathing.
I'm just saying that's wild. And it's okay. Kill me in the comments. I don't care.
I mean, you watch any anime, like, what is this called?
Demon Slayer? Reaction?
No, but like
YouTube channel?
Comment.
No, what's the like type of anime this is?
Shonen.
Any shonen, it's like, oh, Goku got his ass beat. 5 minutes later, oh, he's stronger now.
Yeah.
Because
people in the comments are like, I can't believe you expect him to, like, do so well against the power. Like, clearly you don't understand the power scaling. And this was, like, comparative, the trained demon should be practically far more powerful than Rui. Now, I'll give credit to Rui. Rui's pretty scary as far as all the demons go, far more than the dream demon. But still, if we're power-wise, he's lower than all the other ones.
But that's what I'm saying. He couldn't beat five, and one. So if he can't... Okay. Five is up here. Tantra is down here. Tantra now lost to this. Tantra learned how to do breathing. And number one is probably double the distance, like, to the ceiling. And then he got buffed by Muzan. And now he's probably outside the fucking building. And Tantra somehow just learned to breathe better. And now it's like...
But also the demon admitted that he fucked up. And he didn't let himself become strong. Or didn't, like, use all of his powers because he's fucking dumb.
That's fair. That's fair.
He's like, oh, shit, I lost because I'm bad at with my new powers.
I mean, I will say, too, like, the lower one's abilities, for all intents and purposes, were more, like, hacksy, if that makes sense. Like, they were more, like, hacks than they were, like, pure strength. Whereas, like...
Unlike Akaza, who seems like he's just simply...
Like, yeah, Akaza is, like, clearly just brute strength above all. Even Rui seemed more, like, brute strength.
Rui was so much scarier than the Enmu.
Yeah.
To me.
Because lower one, like, all of his abilities were just, like, other than the train itself and being able to attack with multiple tentacles, it was just, like, hacks abilities that, like, you can't really... If you learn to counter them, it's, like, it doesn't really matter.
Yeah.
Like, you can't counter Akaza's lightning fast speed,
like,
plus his strength.
If you just get an average swordsman up, he's gonna get punched in the stomach and die.
But
you could run away from a tentacle.
Well, and also anybody could learn to, like,
kill yourself in your dreams.
Yeah, or, like, or wear a mask and not be able to tell which way you're looking to block the ability. So,
here's the only two points of credit that I'm gonna give to the commenters this time. Is one, Tanjiro almost got killed.
Yeah.
By losing a grip of reality. So, okay. Inosuke did help. And Enmu, whatever, is a zealot. So, perhaps getting the blood of Muzan got to his dick. He got too excited with his newfound power, you said.
Yeah. Got to his cock and nuts.
Got to his cock and nuts, and he got too excited with his raging...
Yeah.
Hard on.
Yeah, no,
I let it get to my cock and nuts. This is so excited!
He definitely was, like, to me, more dumb than Rui was. But it's still, if you're gonna give this, like, if you're gonna
power
build
scale.
This power scale of, like, one to, or 6-1, 6-1, and one's the strongest by a mile from 5 and 6, and then they get buffed, like, that's just.
Here's another thing I don't want. I really don't want Rengoku to win this fight. If it was a lower, if it was upper 6, I would be fine with it. But upper 3, Like, if Ren Goku wins,
that is simply
like,
the third strongest, or the fourth strongest demon.
Yeah, because then that just means, it just feels like the Hashira could swipe all these guys.
Yeah.
So I kind of don't want Ren Goku to win in that scenario.
Yeah, it's kind of,
I don't want him to die either.
To me, it just depends on, too, like, we don't know how the Hashira rank amongst themselves.
Also
like,
true.
Ren Goku could be the strongest.
He could.
We don't know. But he could also be, like, the fourth weakest, so...
Yeah.
It just kind of depends. I don't know. I don't know where I fall in this, but...
When do we do... I mean, Adam says he knows all the rankings, but...
Like, strength-wise?
He says he knows the rankings of the Hashira, but he hasn't seen the
entertainment history. Did he read the manga?
I don't know,
like,
but I don't think we're going to be getting that in the next episode, so I don't know how he found out that info.
And it does. I don't think they say it because I watch the Entertainment District. I'm pretty sure they don't say it
what
there
the?
Either. I think he's reading ahead again.
Adam,
come on, come on, bro.
Come on, dude.
Maybe cut that out. Cause Gil's like he's reading ahead again.
No one knows. I don't think he does.
Yeah.
Well, he probably gets info by accident.
My favorite spoiler. It's not a real spoiler. I saw a screenshot of a character that we've previously seen. And they have a gun, and I was like, why the fuck is there a gun in this?
Okay. In this show?
Yeah. No. I was like, why the fuck does he have a... Dump?
Is there not guns at this era?
No.
Probably like, muskets, but this dude has, like, a Red Dead Redemption double-barreled shotgun.
No,
What nation was the first to, like, utilize gunpowder?
China?
And they had the fireworks as well came from China?
Yeah.
Well, this is Taisho era, so there's what?
When did Japan get
it? They have electricity, so...
Yeah, that's true. They have trains and electricity.
Yeah, my son.
Also,
but he has a double-barreled shotgun, and I was like, "What am I looking at?"
Okay, who's Akaza's voice actor? Because he said it right.
Oh yeah,
I might have been tripping. I'll look in a second. Hold
okay.
on. Taisho era is the 1900s, so yeah, there's guns.
1900s, yeah. And while you're checking that voice, I don't know if I said it on the channel or not, but Rui was Shigaraki. I think I mentioned that before. Japanese Shigaraki. And for Caleb, while you're doing that, sorry, I know you're multitasking, but
yes.
Rengoku from Vinland. Would you recognize his voice as a Vinland character if I didn't say it?
Is it my favorite character?
He's one of my favorite characters.
Oh, is it the priest?
Yeah, he's Willibald.
Willibald.
That's so weird. But
he's also Sai from Naruto.
Okay, so in Japanese, the word yes, I've heard multiple ways
iterations.
Being said. So the one I'm familiar with, which is most said in Vinland, is Suda.
Suda.
Suda. And Rengoku says Suda, I think. But I feel like other people don't say Suda.
I don't know. I don't know. I'm not sure.
Because I think, isn't Hai? Or is that yes? Yes?
Hai.
Yes.
I thought yes was that.
Okay, so that's not that. I don't know. I know there's
another. I saw one of them, but I don't. I can't find it.
You guys need IMDb. My gosh, you two.
He's looking at the anime. Definitely. I was gonna say he sounded like Tsubokuno.
Who is he?
Gaara
from Naruto, but in Japanese.
Gaara, is that the sand guy?
Yeah,
Sandman.
Boom! I know my Naruto.
He's also
never
a Japanese Persona character, so I'm excited to see him one day.
Tsubokuno. Yeah, I was gonna say I'm like Gaara. He kind of sounds like Goofy Eye.
Goofy Eye looking Gaara, bro.
Oh man. Anyways, yeah.
Sorry. Anyway.
That was not a picture of Gojo.
There wasn't. It was not Gojo.
Okay.
That was not Gojo.
That's not the same.
Ooh, I was like, damn, that's crazy. Okay.
I would have noticed if that was Gojo. I'd be like, yeah, that's him.
Train crashed.
So Rengoku pops up.
Pops.
And then he tells Tanjiro, you know, like, focus on your breathing. Like, you use your nerves to heal. Which, later in the episode, he says it's a fatal wound. So...
you're going to need to see a doctor, buddy. But this will help you not die right now.
But I appreciate it. It was like the good older brother trainer. He's like, bro, focus. Put his finger on his forehead. Like, listen.
You're going
right
to bleed out.
Right here. Focus.
Yeah.
Just pay attention. Everyone's safe. There's only a couple injuries. No one died. Like, you did a good job, kid.
Okay. Why did Akaza show up?
Maybe he was watching the whole time.
You think?
Maybe he's bored.
I mean, I was throwing out that maybe... our demon was going to call out to them, but it didn't happen.
Yeah. I think he probably was just watching out.
It was the most off-the-cuff thing. It was so random.
I mean...
Unless this is not a random event. This is all planned thing.
I mean, it definitely... Well, at least part of it's planned, because Muzan wanted one to kill Hashira.
Yeah,
so,
that's true.
Um,
joint effort.
It may be some... Maybe it's like Muzan sending one of his generals, like, yo, Go look out. See what this lower ranking fellow's doing. Like, is he gonna get it done? And if he doesn't, go fucking finish his job for him.
Yeah, because they've never beaten the Hashira, have they?
The lowers never have. So,
but Akaza said he's beaten many Hashira.
Did he say three or many?
Ooh, many. Yeah, awesome. Out of all the Hashira I've never beat up a flame one.
Yeah.
Also, I kind of want to see the picture of they showed a whole pamphlet of all the other uppers.
Yeah, one of them is a samurai, and I didn't notice that before. That's why I was freaking out.
Right.
Because that looks like a fucking swordsman. Because imagine having a swordsman demon fighting a swordsman Hashira.
Yeah, that's scary.
That's terrifying. If this guy's throwing hands, imagine a demon. That's a master of sword fighting.
Yeah. They also said that, you know, they've all the upper have been alive for centuries too. So it's like they have a lot of
experience.
Like they have a lot of experience, probably have killed plenty of Hashira over time.
Mm. Yeah.
They're there.
Ah, okay. Yeah. I wanted to Since the show gave it to us, I want to kind of cheat ahead and look at what we got to deal with.
So personally, I've seen four of them.
Four of them?
Yeah.
Like in manga or online or like in the show?
In where the show continues.
Wow.
I've seen four out of however many of these.
So there's someone with a fan on the far right. Akaza. A woman.
Whatever that thing is.
A genie in a vase. Yeah, a
djinn
or a genie, and then the samurai.
And a samurai. That samurai looks... He's so far back.
He has to be
like leaps and bounds ahead of all of them if he looks that menacing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Look at him. So cool.
I like the designs. Like, even the silhouettes are pretty awesome. I mean, compared to the lower six, these guys look so
much cooler. The lower six were pretty lame in design.
Bunch of jobbers.
It's also exciting, too, because, I'm not going to lie, Akaza is cool. He doesn't look as cool as some of the other guys on here, too.
Yeah.
Like, as far as all these guys go, they got some cool-looking designs.
Kind of looks like Gaara.
Akaza?
Yeah.
He's like, but he's like a weird mix because this guy's like a martial artist, like big, muscular.
He looks like the guy from the first episode, the OVA of the random dude with the tattoos that fall.
Yeah,
similar.
Similar body tattoos.
He was bald. He had balding issues.
So Akaza rolls up. Yeah. Basically, he wants to run the one-on-one with,
Rengoku.
He almost killed Tanjiro just so he could get the one-on-one with no distractions because he likes the fight.
Yeah.
And he's like, I can sense how strong you are and how like strong will that you have to fight. Become a demon. Basically be my training partner. It was like the whole conversation.
We'll make you stronger.
Yeah.
You'll get stronger over time because you'll live forever.
Yeah, you'll never like peak, basically. Like you will always be at a high level instead of peaking and then coming down because of age, body, health, whatever. I love Rengoku's like, I like vehemently oppose everything you say.
I don't like you.
Be further apart.
Yeah.
He says, I don't like you still.
Yeah. And even like Rengoku's like appreciation for life, like it's like that's like the beauty of it all, like the beginning and the end of like someone's story. It was pretty cool.
Yeah.
Like he doesn't fear death, like that is part of being human.
Yeah.
It's a lot like a homunculus in the flask. Whatever.
The dwarf in the flask.
Yeah.
Comma homunculus.
You simply can't understand why humans would take enjoyment out of being human.
Yeah.
I think it's an interesting premise, like Rengoku being tempted. I don't know if he's felt tempted at all by it. It didn't seem like he really budged on the idea. But I liked that was, like, the prime focus of the fight, where Akaza kept bringing up. And it's just, it's almost a little disrespectful, but also, like, I don't know how to take it. Because Akaza seemed genuine about it. It didn't seem like he was playing around with that.
Yeah,
like, it seemed like,
no, he's dead ass.
Like, it seemed like that was, like, could be a betterment to the demon clan if they could get him under the wing. But at the same time, it's like, hey, it's like, it felt belittling, because, like, if you're not going to accept this, I'm going to kill you. And just because he was not breaking the sweat, it just felt like they were leagues above. Like, he's leagues above Rengoku.
No.
Almost, and like, this is more a play for fun than a mutual exchange.
I mean, even at the end of the fight, too, he was like, don't die yet.
Yeah.
Like, we're not done.
Don't.
You haven't really given me your all.
Let's keep fighting.
Let's keep going.
He hasn't fulfilled his duty.
Yeah.
As a Hashira.
So, It's a little scary, but Akaza's, like, stance that he did, like, yeah. A, his fighting is awesome. I like the air punches. I don't really understand what the whole, like, snowflake diagram underneath of him was, like, what that... He was like
the arrow.
He was like destructive power, and then he just went and started doing air punches. I'm like, I don't really know what.
Have you taken kung fu classes before?
I was like, are we getting like a?
Once fucking... you get your orange belt, as soon as you touch ground, snowflake.
Like, ta-da.
You've unlocked snowflake. What?
The manga of this has to be. Yeah. The manga of this has to be so bland. If none of the powers. If Adam said the powers are added to the show and aren't in the manga,
I think they're in both, but it's just an artistic like showing. Because I don't think it's just sword fighting.
Okay, because that's
like Vagabond,
really
where Vagabond's like sword fighting.
Yeah, no, I don't.
Vagabond's like realistic-ish sword fighting in the manga. This is.
Because that'd be so weird if like because it's such a prime focus of the show: fire move, water move, air punch. And they all do their little things, like, if that doesn't appear in the manga, that's just weird.
Battery's about to die.
Alright, you're back. We're back. Caleb found...
I found proof. Look, they're doing the thing.
Yeah, so... They do have the effects. So I wonder...
It's just the idea, like the author said, that I guess if you were to, like, take the effects out, they're just sword fighting.
Okay.
But this is it's like a creative choice to make it look way cooler.
The show would... lose a lot of its luster. It'd be lackluster. Okay, on the air type, I'm just gonna send this one out into the air and hopefully shoot my shot and get this right. I think demons and their powers can be a derivative of the initial demon slayer power they might have had at a time. Air type, there's air Hashira, we got a wind Hashira. Flowers. I'm staying on that. I'm staying on that Lady Tamaya thing, that maybe she was a trainee, had part of that flower-based power, and this is how it translated. Nezuko, part of the Flame family, this is how her power manifests.
That's her Hinokami Kagura dance.
Because I know she was a little girl compared to Tanjiro, but they both might have learned the Hinokami dance, or learned different forms of it, unbeknownst to themselves. I mean, Tanjiro didn't learn anything. Like, that's all from his memory, and he's able to do it, so... The fact that her power is demon art, but it's fire, like, I don't know. Or maybe there's just, people are inherently meant to be part of some of these different power things, and it just manifests based off of their demon or a demon slayer.
Yeah, I don't know. I just, considering everything comes from Muzan, I just feel like it might be more leaning that way. Also, the only ones that make sense so far are Akaza and maybe Tamayo. Tamaya.
Well, maybe that's origin point this show. Maybe that's origin point this show and say, at the beginning, there was two people, a demon.
God.
In the beginning.
Maybe there was maybe Muzan.
There was light.
Maybe Muzan was the avatar, like we always say Tanjiro was.
Yeah.
I'm dead serious. I'm going to work with this theory. Maybe Muzan was the avatar and had all these powers as demon slayers that we always tease that maybe Tanjiro could get. Because Tanjiro is a special case where... he's a black sword, and they never go far, and they're capable of...
Just like guts. He's making me laugh. He's able to
and
do
he can
burn
get all
everything. Yeah.
Get all those. Maybe Muzan was that. Fell prey to whatever the demon origin is, and then he just has a perverted version of what the Hashira can still achieve. Like, he has the demon versions of those, and passes them on to these guys. That's still up on our screen, the upper... ranked, and maybe we're just seeing two versions of the same powers play out in different ways: dark side, light side.
Possibly.
Yeah. I'm gonna stick.
I'm not gonna completely count it out because we don't know. But no. I just feel like they're just kind of so. All of them are so far. Like what? Where does Ryu's? Where does that fall? What world does that?
Insect.
Bug.
See, that one's different. I would level with you on the arrow demon though, because. Though I feel like that could also be air, because they said that was, like, the arrows aren't really there, it's more just, like, air is pushing him in different directions, because Tanjiro was able to pick up on the arrows.
But he put
really
the thing on his head and he could see the arrows.
Yeah, because it was a demon art that he couldn't see it, that's what,
That's why they stapled the thing.
Yushiguro, or Yushi, whatever
it is. Fushiguro, yeah.
No, not Fushiguro.
I don't know.
Hanami.
Perhaps it's just... seeing through your third eye. Perhaps gravity in real life, when you open your third eye,
open
has
your
arrows.
Pineal gland.
Maybe there's just millions of arrows that pull us down to Earth, but you need your third eye to see it.
DMT.
LSD, one of them. It was a really good episode.
The fight was amazing, though. The fight's really cool. I am scared for Rengoku's fate. Why the hell does Akaza and a lot of the demons be able to just, like, you know what I mean? They're just able to just, like...
He's impressive.
He is very impressive.
I like the fisticuffs.
Yeah.
And I like that he can regen so fast.
He beat an ass.
I loved how he got sliced down the hand and then, like...
It just snapped. Oh, dude.
The octopus style. It's really disgusting. But
well, because he could hold up, like, this part of his arm and the other was just, like, hanging. And then he just, like, and just, like, snapped it back together. Oh,
missing arms.
Yeah. I like that. That is a cool thing about this show. The whole, like, automatic pop-outs.
I think that's about it. Is there anything else on this episode?
I don't know what he got hit by, but Rengoku was, like, struggling.
I don't understand what happened.
Well, he did get... He got clipped in the face, clipped in the eye again. And then they collide or whatever, and he's just like...
I was like, oh, no, are we going to do the typical samurai thing where they slice, and then it's like, we don't know what happened?
Well, they got a slice, and then they got a holster both their swords at the same time, and then one of them falls over.
Well, Akaza also, like, went into the shadows, so we don't even know if he got, like, even really clipped like that.
The only thing I'll say, like, I agree with Adam for the outro, or the intro, how it can appear as a spoiler. Like, I think it would have been cool
if we didn't know he was coming.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, the reveal, because he's in the intro. And the tease of Rengoku suffering something, an injury of some sort, is pretty much teased with Tanjiro charging him with flame. To what extent, I still feel like that's not super... I'd say the most spoiler thing is Akaza appearing in the show.
I don't know.
Is that I was, like, looking, waiting for him to appear.
I guess my problem with that is just, like, as...
Like, I don't even like an AOT when they, like, spoil...
Yeah, I get that, but it's, like, as a fan base, are we all going to decide that we don't like this and, like, influence the artists and the companies that make this to stop doing that? Or are we all just going to watch it and then be like manga readers and then just complain that non-manga readers saw something ahead of time because they put it... Like, it's a part of the culture of anime to have intros. They've been there from the fucking beginning.
Oh, I love intros.
I know. I'm not saying you don't like intros.
I think they should,
like,
go back to lying. Remember, you know,
like
Full Metal lies.
Yeah, you
Full Metal just straight up lies to you.
And I like the Full Metal intros because they okay. The most recent one's not a good example because they kind of tease someone returning
to
the show.
Yeah, some of them do.
But I'll say, like, I like when they keep up in the air. Like, My Hero, I think, is the best example. They still tease things that could be seen in the show, but sometimes they kind of just juice it up in ways that doesn't happen. But you can get an idea, but it's not like...
Yeah. If it wasn't ingrained in the culture already, then, like, I'm with you. Like,
oh, yeah.
But it's just, like, as a
thing at this point.
But it's hard. It's, like, you... I get it. Like, it's very easy to just, like, fast forward and not watch it. But it's also, like, I don't want to watch the whole series, never watch the intro, and then, like, go and watch the intro at the end.
Oh, yeah.
And it's, like...
I'm not trying to stop us watching intros. I love the
intros.
I like intros a whole lot.
I know you're not. I'm just saying for, like... The detractors, like the ones that don't want,
like,
you to
discourage from watching.
Yeah, the people that discourage it from watching it, and that's like, I get it, but it's like, okay, if we all decide as a community, and I'm not gonna sit here and be like, I'm the guy that's leaving the anime community. I'm not.
No, you are.
I'm not the one who should.
You are the guy.
No, I'm not.
The main character. Come on, Will.
But
Nosuke.
The main character complex of this.
But I'm like, I mean, whoever it is, like, they just need to decide, like, we're not gonna do that. And it's like, even like, you can glean stuff from, like, cover art and like...
Yeah,
Tengen
playing a big role in Entertainment District. He's on, like, the bloody main picture of it.
Fuck the cover for Attack on Titan Season 4 that we would see every time we opened up the app well before we even got to it.
Oh, my gosh.
That's
the potential Nazis and the giant Eren.
Yeah.
Hello, Eren doing...
And it's like, okay, we, of course, don't know because you don't have context, but it's the same thing. It's like...
Eventually, you'll be able to come to conclusions when you get farther.
When you get farther into series, but, like, in the beginning, you don't. So it's, I don't know. I just think it's, like, a mute point to even, like, really get upset about it.
That's,
like, a fan, but
yeah,
it is what it is.
When
are you doing an anime intro video? compilation video.
Compilation? What does that mean?
Like I saw Mizkif watch the top 100 ones.
Interesting. Channel idea.
I keep pitching them the sim and he shoots them down.
Yeah, guys, if you made it this far, please help us out. Like this video. Subscribe to the channel if you've not already done so. We appreciate your support. I know it's hard to remember those things you watch our content and you forget about it, but remember to support your boys. Even Adam, who's not here, we'll see you soon in the next finale. Punch it! Bah!
Goodbye!